Good morning. This is Mark LaFave from the Stearns County Soil and Water Conservation District with your conservation report. And today I'd like to talk about the nitrogen fertilizer rule. The Minnesota Department of Ag is developing this nitrogen fertilizer rule and is seeking public comment. The purpose of the rule is to minimize potential sources of nitrate pollution in the state's groundwater and to protect our drinking water. The rule is a draft and may change based on public input and is expected to be adopted in the fall of 2018. The rule is based on the Minnesota Nitrogen Fertilizer Management Plan, which recommends steps for the prevention and minimization of the impacts of nitrogen fertilizer on groundwater and emphasizes involving the local agricultural community in problem solving for local groundwater concerns. Nitrate nitrogen is one of the most common contaminants in Minnesota's groundwater. The majority of Minnesota households have access to safe drinking water supplies. However, in areas vulnerable to groundwater contamination, some public and private wells may have high nitrate levels. Too much nitrate in drinking water can pose serious health problems. The Department of Agriculture is currently seeking public input. The rulemaking process involves reviews by the governor, public comment periods, and steps for public notification. 5 listening sessions will be held throughout the state to learn more about the draft rule and participate in question and answer sessions. And one session is at the Great River Regional Library right here in St. Cloud on July 6th at 3 p.m. And Department of Ag staff will be available to answer questions and to receive written comments. The rule is based on the nitrogen fertilizer best management practices developed by the University of Minnesota. Use of nitrogen fertilizer best management practices can minimize the loss of nitrogen into the environment. The rule is designed to involve local farmers and agronomists in adopting and promoting best management practices and other practices that can reduce nitrate in groundwater. And the rule contains 2 parts. Each part contains separate criteria and requirements. Depending on a farm's location, the rule may apply in one part, both parts, or maybe not at all. So part 1 is fall and frozen fertilizer restriction. So if a farm is located in a vulnerable groundwater area, nitrogen fertilizer application in fall and on frozen soils will be restricted. Soil hydrology and geology information will be used to identify vulnerable groundwater areas. And part 2 is following nitrogen fertilizer best management practices. The Department of Ag and Minnesota Department of Health extensively monitor both private and public drinking water wells for nitrate. If a farm is located in an area that has high concentrations of nitrate in groundwater, the rule lays out a process for mitigation. And mitigation is the action of reducing the severity of a problem. The rule proposes 4 mitigation levels with increasing restrictions. Use of nitrogen fertilizer, best management practices, and alternative practices are key components of part 2 of the rule. So again, if you'd like to give input into the nitrogen fertilizer rule, you can attend a listening session at the Great River Regional Library in St. Cloud on July 6th at 3 p.m. To wrap up, I have a couple dates to keep in mind. First, the Natural Resources Conservation Service announced the deadline to apply for the 2018 Environmental Quality Incentive Program, or EQIP, is August 18th, 2017. And EQIP is the main cost share or financial assistance program we use to assist landowners in implementing conservation practices. Whether your resource concern is a gully erosion or manure storage or nutrient management on cropland, or you'd like to see how cover crops fit into your cropping system, EQIP is usually the program we start with to help out producers. And again, that sign-up deadline is August 18th. And finally, a save the date. into the future here. To keep in mind, if you're interested in cover crops, is September 20th. And the Sherburne Soil and Water Conservation District is hosting a Soil Health Field Day that includes a presentation from Jay Fuhrer, who is an excellent speaker on soil health and cover crops. They also have demonstration plots with interseeded cover crops and nitrogen source comparison. And that's September 20th at the Haven Township Hall, just east of St. Cloud. If you have questions about any of these topics, you can always call our office at 320-251-7800 or check us out on our website, and that's stearnscountyswcd.net. Again, this is Mark LaFave from the Stearns County Soil and Water Conservation District with your weekly conservation report, and thanks for listening.